Hi students, welcome to Evershine Coaching Center. Myself, Shah Faisal sir here. Dear students, today we are going to continue the chapter of science, chemical reactions and equations. My dear students, in the previous class we have discussed few chemical reactions and their properties. How to determine whether the chemical reaction has taken place or not. By observing some activities, we have understood how the reaction is going to take place. And I just got some feedback from most of the students. Sir, in the last moment, what you have explained, we cannot able to listen it properly. Right? No problem. Again, I am going to continue. Just we have done the experiments here from which we have identified how to determine or how to check whether in the given reaction, in the given chemical, whether the reaction is going to take place or not. Children, in this reaction you can observe, here what we have done, we have taken the quicklime, okay, we have combined with water. When quicklime we have added with water, what happens? The quicklime is going to react with water. How can we get to know whether the quicklime has reacted with water? By observing their temperature. Before you have taken the quantity of water and you have taken some quantity of quicklime separately, if you can touch and feel, it is just in the normal temperature. But when these both added together, that is quicklime and water, what happens? It converts into slake-like. That is a product. But here I am not concentrating on the product side. Okay? But reaction has happened. How can we get to know whether the reaction has taken place or not? By observing their temperature. Now it has become hot. That is in warm condition. Similarly, what we have done here, we have taken the ammonium chloride. We have combined with barium hydroxide. Again here also some reaction is going to take place and we get one product. Now I want to know whether the reaction has taken place or not. If you touch the beaker, it will be in the cold condition. First it was in normal temperature. But now if you feel, you can touch and feel the beaker, it has converted into cold state. It means temperature has decreased. So temperature is also a condition which tells us how the whether the reaction has taken place or not. My dear students, in your exam, what they can do is, they may give you one activity, they can give you one experiment. Here as I have said you, take one beaker, in that we have added this, we have added that, like that they will give you specific conditions. They will give one small kind of a story. Now only one question they will ask you, from this experiment, just tell me whether the chemical reaction has taken place or not. If it has taken place, then give reason. Like this type of questions you will be getting. In this, what they will do, very simple. If you are reading that experiment or the activity what they have given in your question paper, either they will give you the state change, or they may give you the color change, or they may tell you some precipitate is being formed, or some gas is liberated, or heat is absorbed, or heat is liberated. They may give you any of these condition. Okay, you have to read it carefully. If you can see any one condition in that experiment, then you can directly tell that yes, chemical reaction has taken place, and you can tell the reason why. Because color has changed. First it was in this color, but now it has changed into this color. First it was in solid state, but now it is in gaseous state. First there was no gas liberated, but no gas has liberated. Like that you can give the specific reason. Got it? Now, as we have discussed in activity 1.2 in your textbook, you can see here, in this activity 1.2, can you see children? In this activity 1.2? Yeah. In this activity 1.2, they have discussed about lead nitrate solution and potassium hydroxide solution. Okay, here we can see children's lead nitrate solution, actually it is colorless, okay, and potassium iodine, again this is also colorless. When this both we are combining together, when we are adding together, what happens? Okay, this is nitrate solution and this is potassium iodine solution. When this both we have combined, this both are actually colorless. Do not forget it. This both are actually colorless. This both are initially colorless. When we have combined together these colorless solutions, so what happens? We can see a yellow color precipitate is formed here. Can you see this? One yellow color precipitate is formed. That is nothing but lead iodine. Now from this change also we can tell that a chemical reaction has taken place. You can see before and after. What is the difference? Now it is colorless, but now it is colorful. Now there is a color, that is yellow color. So this yellow color is very important, children. So you need to remember the color. Okay, so lead iodine is the precipitate. Do not forget it. So this is what actually we have discussed in the previous class, how the chemical reaction has taken place or whether the chemical reaction has taken place or not. Understood? Good. Now, my dear students, now what we will be doing here is, now we are discussing about chemical equation. Chemical equation. Now we are discussing the topic chemical equations. My dear students, now what exactly is this meaning of chemical equation? Say children, chemical equation, it is nothing but it's just a statement, children. It is a statement used in chemistry. It is a statement which we are using in chemistry to represent a chemical reaction. So chemical equation, it is a statement which is used in chemistry to represent a chemical reaction. Dekho beta, chemical equation ka matlab wo ek statement hai jiske andar chemical reaction usme जिस तरह से हुआ है उसको हम रिप्रेजेंट कर रहे हैं. केमिकल इक्वेशन ಏನಂದ್ರೆ ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ನಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಏನಕ್ಕೆ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದೀವಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅದು ಒಂದು ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ನಮಗೆ ಹೇಳುತ್ತೆ ಯಾವ ತರ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ನಾವು ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಇಕ್ವೇಷನ್. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಇಕ್ವೇಷನ್. ಮೈ ಡಿಯರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಒನ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೆಲ್ ಯು ದಟ್ in activity 1.2, just know what we have seen. In that, we have already observed when silver nitrate solution react with sodium chloride solution, a white precipitate of silver chloride and sodium nitrate is formed. Right, children? So, in activity 1.2, can you remember? In activity 1.2, what we have done? If you have your textbook, you can see. We have taken the lead nitrate solution, potassium iodine solution, right? There we got yellow precipitate, no? Yeah. Similar to that, even if we take silver nitrate. If we take instead of lead, we are taking silver nitrate. You can take lead or you can take silver, no problem. But here now what we are doing? So when silver nitrate solution reacts with sodium chloride, sodium chloride solution, so which color of precipitate is formed? If these both reacts with each other, which type of precipitate is formed? A white precipitate is formed, children. Remember this color. Which type of precipitate? A white precipitate. There yellow we got, right? But here we get white precipitate. Are you getting, children? A white precipitate of silver chloride and sodium nitrate is formed. Now till now what all I have said you, this we are writing in a statement. Actually we are not writing this plus all those things. We are writing this complete story in a statement. That is what we call it as chemical equation. Means the same reaction what is happening here, we are writing in complete sentence form. We are writing these all things in complete sentence form, that is nothing but the example of chemical equation. Understood, children? Similarly, in one more activity we have seen, when magnesium ribbon is burnt in oxygen, a magnesium ribbon when we burnt in oxygen, you have to write in sentence actually, okay, it gets converted into magnesium oxide. It converts it into magnesium oxide. So this is also we are writing in a statement form. This statement, what it shows, how the reaction is happening, it explains us the complete story. That is what, as an example of chemical equation. However, children, in this description of a chemical reaction in the form of a sentence is quite long, correct? Now, whatever we are telling, this complete story, it makes us to write in 2 to 3 lines or 4 lines, sometimes in a paragraph also, right? It means it is completely long method. Correct, children? The same story, what we are explaining, how the reaction is happening, it is completely a quite long method. It is quite long. Yes or no, children? It's quite long method. Understood? So this is what the drawback of chemical equation. This is the drawback of chemical equation. Because in chemical equation, if you are writing, we have to write in a very long form. Understood? But it can be written in a simpler form also, children. We can convert this long form into simpler form. Yes, it is not like always we can write in a long form with it. Even we also can write this in a simpler form also. The simplest way to do this, to write in the form of a words. Okay. The same thing, instead of writing magnesium ribbon, what I will do? I will write this complete sentence in a simple form, that is nothing but word form. In a word equation. Even we can write this in a word equation. In word equation, what we do is, instead of using to represent substance involved in the reaction, understood? In word equation, we use what? We use only the words. We only use the words. Understood? Like example, magnesium ribbon is combined with oxygen. Okay, we told that story, right? We didn't write here plus actually. We have to write in a sentence form like this. Combined with oxygen in air to get or to convert it into magnesium oxide. We are writing these all things, right? But in word form, we can just write magnesium. It is understandable that, yes, example like the first we took the lead nitrate, no? Just you write like this. Lead nitrate plus potassium iodine. Potassium iodine gives lead iodine plus potassium nitrate. Okay, this is what we are writing in a word form. That was in a sentence form. The same chemical equation also we can write in a word form. Children, this side we call it as reactant. This side we call it as reactant, and this side we call it as product. This is reactant and this is product. One more example. Magnesium plus oxygen gives us magnesium oxide. Same chemical equation we are writing not in a sentence form, we are writing in a word form here. That's it. So out of which, what is this, children? So this is reactant, and what is this, children? This is nothing but product. Correct, no, children? This is reactant and this is product. It means, what is the meaning of reactant? Reactant is nothing but the substances that undergo chemical change. So these are the substances which is undergoing with chemical change. So this is going to change their state. So these are the substances which is undergoing with a chemical change, as with the above word, as above the word equations what we have given here. Can you see here one equation we have given here, also one equation here we have given, right? So these are called as reactants. Now what is product? Products are nothing but द न्यू सब्सटेंसेस विच आर फॉर्म्ड, द न्यू सब्सटेंसेस विच आर फॉर्म ड्यूरिंग द रिएक्शन, व्हेन द रिएक्शन इज हैपनिंग, सॉरी आफ्टर द रिएक्शन वी गेट ए न्यू सब्सटेंस, दैट न्यू सब्सटेंस विच हैज फॉर्म्ड दैट इज नोन एज प्रोडक्ट, दैट इज नोन एज प्रोडक्ट. वी कैन सी हियर लेड नाइट्रेट एंड पोटेशियम आयोडीन, दिस इज रिएक्टेंट, एंड लेड आयोडीन एंड पोटेशियम नाइट्रेट इज प्रोडक्ट. इज दिस क्लियर चिल्ड्रन? सो वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ रिएक्टेंट एंड प्रोडक्ट? यस, which is going undergoing chemical change, that is known as reactant, and substances which is formed newly, that is called as product. जो change होने जा रहे हैं उनको हम reactant बोलते हैं, जो हमारे को नई चीज जो मिली है हम उसको क्या बोलते हैं? Product. ಯಾವುದು reaction ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ change ಆಗಕ್ಕೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ reactant ಅಂತೀವಿ. Change ಆದ್ಮೇಲೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಏನ್ ಸಿಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವೇನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ? Product. Are you getting children? I hope you have understood this. In both the activities we have discussed, right? Very good. Now children, now one more thing which I like to tell you. Like a word equation shows a change of reactants to product. In word equation, what did we noticed? In word equation, what did we noticed? We have noticed that हमने क्या दिखाया बेटा word equation के अंदर? हमने word equation में क्या दिखाया बोले तो बेटा? Change of reactants to product. Change of reactants to products. Correct, no? So how the reactant is converted into product, we can see in the word equation. Children, one small note here. You should know this very important note. Sir, what is this note? Note means points to remember. See children, a change is represented by an arrow. Can you see this arrow? This type of arrow, if you are writing in the equation, okay, this arrow shows that there is some change is happening. This shows the change. If you are writing this arrow, this shows the change in the reaction. Should not forget it. The change is represented by an arrow sign. This is the sign which we are using. This is the sign which you are using to determine change. Now sometimes we write equal between reactants and products. Sometimes we also write this type of sign, equal, okay, between reactant and product. This is only in few cases we write here, but during the reaction usually we represent arrow mark only, okay, don't worry. Anyways, the reactants are written on the left hand side. Always we write the reactants on which side? In left hand side. Should not forget it. Always we write the reactant in left hand side with plus between them, with plus between them. Are you getting children? We use this symbol plus. We are using plus in between them. Similarly, the products are written in the right hand side. Where we write the product? We write the product in the right hand side with a plus sign again, with again plus sign between them, okay. So arrowhead points towards the product side. Always remember the arrowhead. Arrowhead means, so this is known as arrowhead. This is arrowhead, okay. So this arrowhead, what it shows children? It shows where is the product, okay. Where is the product? Should not forget it children. The arrowhead point towards the product, which shows the direction of the reaction, how the reaction is happening. For an example, we have taken magnesium, yes, correct, plus C. Because if anything has to react, definitely we want two or three substances, right? Only one substance cannot undergo with in one substance without any external energy, it won't break, right? If it has to break, either you have to pass some external energy, or you have to take one more substance, you have to react with each other, right? Similarly here also, when, can you see here, magnesium and oxygen, see here, in the left hand side, we are writing in between two substances, a symbol is plus. So this is the arrow, arrowhead is towards right hand side, it means product is coming in the right hand side. It gives magnesium oxide. It gives magnesium oxide. Correct, no children? So this is our reactant and this is the product. But here only one product is formed, so we write only one word, one name. If we are getting two products, again between these two products, we write plus and one more substance name. Understood, children? So this is what your chemical reaction, sorry, chemical equation. That is what, even in our textbook also, we have discussed the same thing. You can see here, in activity 1.1, we have described when magnesium ribbon is burnt in oxygen, it gets converted into magnesium oxide. So this description of a chemical reaction in sentence form is quite long. So we are writing that in a shorter form, right? The simplest way of writing in the form is word equation. Always we represent in a word equation like magnesium plus oxygen, that is reactant. Arrowhead is towards right hand side. So this is a magnesium oxide. The substances that undergo chemical change in the reaction, that is magnesium and oxygen, are called as reactant. And new substances which is formed, that is like magnesium oxide, that is known as product. So always we write the word equation, reactant and products, through an arrow placed between them. The reactants are written on the left hand side with plus between them. Similarly, products are written in the right hand side with a plus between them. Arrowhead point towards the product and shows the direction of the reaction. Right, children? That is what we have discussed, right? Yeah. I hope you have understood. Very good. Now, children, how to write a chemical equation? How we are discussing how to write the chemical equation. Children, before we go for that how to write the chemical equation, I just want to tell you one more topic. That is nothing but we also use symbol equations. We also use this type of equations. Just now we have discussed chemical equation can be written in long method. So same chemical equation we also write in word form. And also we can write in symbol form also. We can also write this in symbol form. So there is another shorter and popular method. So this is still more shorter method. This is still more shorter method compared to word method. Compared to word method, that is known as simple equation method. It's a very popular method. A chemical equation may be made in more concise and useful. Okay, we can still concise, we can decrease the size, we can decrease the size. How to decrease the size? By using symbols. What we are doing, children? We are using symbols and chemical formulae. We are using symbols and what? We are using symbols and chemical formulae instead of words. Instead of words. Are you getting, children? Instead of words. For an example, you can see here, you should know the symbols actually. Okay. We told magnesium, right? But here I will write just Mg. What is the meaning of Mg? That is magnesium. Combines with oxygen, O2. It gives magnesium oxide. See here, still it is becoming still more shorter form, right? Mg means magnesium, O2 means oxygen, MgO means magnesium oxide. Okay, so this type of representing the equation, this is nothing but the shorter method, that is shorter equations. Okay. A shortened representation of a chemical change in terms of symbols and formula of the substances which is involved in this reaction. Okay. Similarly, one more we can take. One more equation like sodium carbonate. Means we write Na2CO3. That is sodium carbonate. When we combine this with sulfuric acid, that is H2SO4. We are not writing sulfuric acid. We are using the formula. Okay. It gives what? Sodium sulfate, that is Na2SO4 plus carbon dioxide CO2. Are you getting, children? Can you see this? Even here also we have used what? We have used the symbols to represent how the chemical reaction is going to take place. Is this clear? Is this clear, children? Yes, that is shorter format. Now, next new heading. Steps for writing a chemical equation. Steps how to write a chemical equation. You should know this. What is step number one? They may not ask you in exam, but you should know these steps, okay? Okay, they will not ask you write the steps to write the chemical equation, the kind of thing, but you should know the steps. So first, what we should do, children? Always remember, for if you want to write a chemical equation, the following points has to be kept in your mind. Very importantly, what is the first point? The symbols in formula of the reacting substance, that is nothing but reactants. That is nothing but reactants. Symbols and formula of reacting substance, that is reactants, are written in the left hand side. Always we have to write this in the left hand side. Reactants has to be left written in the left hand side with plus sign. Next point you should remember, the symbols and formula of various products, the products, the new products which is formed, right? That where we have to keep in the right hand side with plus between them. If you are getting two products, then you have to write plus in between them. Understood? And third point, what children? We have to use arrowhead. We have to use arrow sign, which is heading towards product side. So this symbol, arrow sign, or equality sign, or we can also use equality is put between reactant and products. Correct? We can give an example. When zinc reacts with sulfuric acid to give zinc sulfate plus hydrogen gas. We can see we have written reactant in left hand side and product we have written in the right hand side. Correct, no children? So these are the steps you need to remember while solving or while writing the chemical equation. Correct, children? So you here also we can see writing a chemical equation is there any other shorter way to represent the chemical equation? Yes, chemical equation can be more concise and useful if we use chemical formula instead of words. Instead of using formula, we are using in a word form. A chemical equation represents a chemical reaction. If you recall formula of magnesium, oxygen, magnesium oxide, that is magnesium means Mg, oxygen means O2, magnesium oxide means MgO. Okay, count and compare the number of atoms in each element on LHS and RHS by off an arrow. Anyhow, I am going to explain you this paragraph, but just you remember till here what I have explained you. Right? Now, see children, now here we discuss two types of chemical equations. We have two types of chemical equations. One is called as balanced chemical equation and unbalanced chemical equation. We have two types of chemical equation, that is balanced and unbalanced. Unbalanced chemical equation. Okay. Now, so what is the meaning of balanced and unbalanced? I'll tell you, children. So consider the chemical equation for the reaction, okay, of zinc, when it is reacting with sulfuric acid, that is H2SO4. Okay, what happens? It forms, or it converts, or it gives zinc sulfate, that is ZnSO4, and next hydrogen, that is H2. Now, see children, so when zinc reacts with sulfuric acid, it gives zinc sulfate and hydrogen. See children, Zn is plus, H is plus, SO4 is minus. Always this side positive and this side negative will react, and this side positive and this side negative will react. So here is Zn, when it reacts with SO4, it becomes ZnSO4, means zinc sulfate. Okay, when hydrogen reacts with, here any negative is there? No. So hydrogen remains as it is, that is H2. Okay, now what you should do is you have to count the numbers of atoms. You have to count the number of atoms. You should count the number of atoms of different elements on both sides. Aapko do jagah bhi unke atoms ko count karna hai, left hand side and right hand side. Jaise ki example, one example, we take element name here. And here we write number of atoms, of reactants, number of atoms of reactants, and here again number of atoms of products, number of atoms of products. See children, now which are the elements are here? We can see Zn is there, correct? Hydrogen is there, SO4 is there. See, this complete SO4, here also complete SO4, then you should take SO4. Here if it was SO4, here it was SO2, then S is separate, O is separate. Since SO4 completely one element, here also SO4 completely one element. So here what all we can see? We have the symbols, Zn we have, next hydrogen we have, next sulfur we have, correct? Next we have sulfur. If you want, you can take SO4 as completely one. If not, you can take it as S separate, O separate also. Okay, but here actually we take SO4 completely only one element. But this is the first example, so I am taking separately, so that it will give you better clarity. Now count in LHS side. Can you see here? This side, Zn. How many Zn is there? One Zn. One. Correct? One atom. Okay, or one mole also we sometimes pronounce it anyhow. So one atom of zinc is there. Next, how many hydrogen we have? Two hydrogens. How many S we have? One S. How many O we have? Four O. Now come back to the RHS side. How many Zn we have? One Zn. How many S we have? One S. How many O we have? Four O. How many H we have? 2H. Now can you add this total? Shall we add this total? 1 plus 2, 3, 3 plus 1, 4, 4 plus 4, 8. Total 8. Can you add here? 1 plus 2, 3, 3 plus 1, 4, 4 plus 4, 8. Yes. Now this type of equations are called as balanced equation, because the number of atoms are completely equal of reactants with products. Okay. It means the number of atoms which is present in the left hand side, it is equal to the number of atoms which is present in the right hand side. So such a type of equation is known as balanced chemical equation. So what is balanced chemical equation, children? Balanced chemical equation is nothing but there are equal number of atoms of different elements in the reactant and product, equal number of atoms of different elements in the reactant and products. So such an equation is called as balanced chemical equation. Balanced chemical equation. Now, you understood now what is the meaning of balanced chemical equation? Both the sides it is same. Now we take one more example. Mg, magnesium, when it reacts with oxygen, it gives us magnesium oxide, correct? Now can we write here atom's name? That is element, number of atoms which is present in reactant and number of atoms present in product. Correct? Yeah. Now shall we write the element names? Mg is there, O is there. Correct? No? What is there, children? We have magnesium, we have oxygen, we have. Correct? Now can we count in the reactant side how many Mg we have? 1 Mg. How many oxygen we have? 2 oxygens. 2 atoms of oxygen. Now can you see the product? This side. How many Mg we have? 1 Mg. How many oxygen we have? 1 oxygen. Can you count here? Total is 3. Can you count here? Total is 2. Now can you tell here LHS is equals to RHS? No, LHS does not equals to RHS. In the before case, LHS and RHS both are equal, but in this case, LHS is not equal to RHS. It means that it is completely clear that the number of atoms of each element are not same on both sides. Correct? It is not same on both the sides. So this type of equations are called as unbalanced chemical equation. If LHS and RHS, if reactant and products both are equal, then it is known as balanced chemical equation. If reactants and products are completely different, then it is known as unbalanced chemical equation. Now, सर इट इज अनबैलेंस्ड, कैन वी लीव दैट एज इट इज, ऐसे हम छोड़ सकते हैं क्या? नो वी कैन नॉट लीव दैट, बट बिफोर दैट आई विल टेल यू वन मोर इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक, ओके, दैट इज दिस इज कंप्लीटली अगेंस्ट द अनबैलेंस्ड केमिकल इक्वेशन व्हिच वी हैव गॉट. नो दिस इज कंप्लीटली अगेंस्ट द लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मास. लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मास, लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मास, व्हाट इट सेज? इट सेज दैट ऑलवेज एल एस एस शुड बी इक्वल टू, आई मीन द एनर्जी इज नाइदर बी क्रिएटेड नॉर बी डिस्ट्रॉयड, करेक्ट? नो, व्हाट इज लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मास? सेज दैट द एनर्जी कैन नाइदर बी क्रिएटेड और नॉर बी डिस्ट्रॉयड, करेक्ट? सो ऑलरेडी वी हैव स्टडीड दिस इन प्रीवियस क्लास, द लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मास. इफ यू आर राइटिंग इन अ सेंटेंस फॉर्म, वी कैन ऑल्सो राइट दिस एज द टोटल मास ऑफ रिएक्टेंट्स बिफोर केमिकल रिएक्शन शुड बी इक्वल टू द टोटल मास ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट्स आफ्टर द केमिकल रिएक्शन. व्हाट लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मास सेज? टोटल मास ऑफ द रिएक्टेंट्स, टोटल मास ऑफ द रिएक्टेंट्स बिफोर द केमिकल, before the chemical reaction, total mass of the reactant before the chemical reaction is equal to the total mass of products, total mass of the products after chemical reaction. After chemical reaction, in other words, we can say that an atom is neither be created nor be destroyed, correct? It cannot be created or nor be destroyed during the chemical reaction. So therefore, the number of atoms of each kind in the reactants must be equal to those in the product side. So that is what law of conservation of mass says. But unbalanced chemical equation is acting against to the law of conservation of mass, correct? It is acting against to law of conservation of mass. So children, I can define you here one statement, you should remember this. What is that? Make a note. A chemical equation which has an equal number of atoms, of each element, in the reactants, and products is called, a balanced equation, is called as a balanced chemical equation. Understood? Now one more sentence you can just take down, that is a chemical equation, in which the number of atoms, of each kind, are not equal, in the reactant and products is called unbalanced, chemical equation, So children, remember one more very important note. This unbalanced chemical equation It is also called, it is also called as skeletal equation. It is also called as skeletal equation. Okay. Now, I'll give you one small activity. I'm giving one small activity for you all. How to now just let me know whether your chemical reaction has taken place or not. So, okay. See, children, now you should tell me in this. Now, this is the homework for you. Check. Just you want to check. That's it. Okay. Check whether chemical reaction. Check whether. Instead of that, check whether it is balanced or unbalanced chemical equation. Okay, so this is one small homework for you. You want to check whether it is balanced chemical equation or unbalanced chemical equation. Yes, children, you can see here H2 plus O2 gives H2O, 2H2 plus O2 gives 2H2O, Fe plus Cl2 gives FeCl3, 2Fe plus Cl2 gives 2FeCl3, Na plus H2O gives NaOH plus H2, 2Na plus 2H2O gives 2NaOH plus H2, KClO3 gives KCl plus O2, 2KClO3 gives 2KCl plus 3O2, N2 plus H2 gives NH3, N2 plus 3H2 gives 2NH3. Okay, so now you can just copy down these things and you can just tell me the answers, which one is balanced and which one is unbalanced. If you want, you can create the table like before what I have shown you, like element name, number of atoms of reactant side and number of atoms on the product side, you can write. Okay, now just to get practice, you can just draw the table and you can write the element's name and check how many number of atoms are present in that. Okay, so in that, by using that method, you can check whether it is balanced or unbalanced equation. Okay, is this clear, children? Now, children, if it is unbalanced, how to convert that into balanced equation? Okay. Let me see. For an example, 2H2 plus O2 gives 2H2O. ठीक है बेटा? 2H2 plus O2 क्या मिल रहा है हमारे को? 2H2O मिल रहा है. 2H2 plus O2 यावा का ना वेरडो को कंबाइन मारता है दीवी. नमके 2H2O बंदी दे. सिक्की दे. इधर ले. In this, what is 2H2? What is 2H2? 2H2 means 2H2 means 4 atoms of hydrogen. 4 atoms of hydrogen. 2H2 means what, children? 4 atoms of hydrogen. Okay. It means the total mass of 4 atoms of hydrogen is 4. The total mass of 4 atoms of hydrogen. So this is 4 atoms of hydrogen. Here 2. And here 2. Understood? So that is nothing but 2 into 2. It is 2 into 2, 4. So it is nothing but 4 atoms of hydrogen. Understood? So what is the atomic mass of hydrogen? That is 1U. Atomic mass of hydrogen is 1U. But you no need to go so deep. Just you remember 2H2 means 4 atoms of hydrogen. Next point, O2. We have in reactant O2. What is O2 means? O2 means 2 atoms of oxygen. 2 atoms of oxygen. It means the total mass of oxygen is how much? What is the total mass of? Now I'll tell you here. What is the total mass of hydrogen? Total mass of hydrogen is how much? How much, children? Total mass of hydrogen, that is equals to 4. Now, what is total mass of oxygen? Total mass of oxygen is how much, children? Total mass of oxygen is 2 into 16. This is actually 4 into 1 is equals to 4. 2 into 16, that is equals to 32 U, and this is 4 U. Understood? Total mass of hydrogen is 4 into 1, that is 4 U. Total mass of oxygen is, because here what is this 1? What is this 1 and what is this 16? This 1 and 16 is nothing but atomic mass number. What is this called as? This we call it as atomic mass number. Atomic mass number of different elements are different. Okay, atomic mass of hydrogen is 1 and atomic mass of oxygen is 16. Okay, 4 into 1 gives 4 U and 2 into 16, always you have to multiply by 16. What is the total mass we have here? Here we have O2, no? This 2 we have to multiply by 16, that is 32 U. If it was 4, 4 into 16. If it is 10, 10 into 16. This 16 will not change. This atomic mass number will not change. Okay, understood. What is the total mass on left hand side? What is the total mass on left hand side? Total mass on left hand side is 36 U. 36 U. Understood. Is this clear? Good. I hope you have understood now. So, what exactly is the meaning of total mass? But actually, in your exam, they won't ask you this type of calculation. Just it is points to remember. Just you can remember this. Okay. So, how to pronounce? How to pronounce? 2H2 means 2 to the 4. That is 4H we have. How many H we have? 4H. How many O we have? 2O. Again, in RHS side, you see. In RHS side. How many H we have? 2 to the 4H. Okay. Now, I am telling about RHS side. But for your exam, this part is important. Can you see here? This part is important. 2 into 2, that is 2H2, means 4 atoms. 4 atoms of hydrogen. This is very important. 2O2 means 2 atoms of oxygen. 2 atoms of oxygen. This is important. Okay. Now, what we have here in RHS side? In RHS side, what we have, children? Just a minute. 2H2O we have, correct? No, in RHS side we have 2H2O. So, what is this 2H2O? How to use this? See, children. So, this is 2. Can you see here the number which we are writing before H2O? This 2 will multiply with H also, and this 2 will multiply with O also. With already H, we have this 2. So, this H2, can you see this 2? This 2 belongs to only H. If we write here in the beginning, then it will multiply with H also, then it will multiply with O also. देखो बेटा, जब भी आप नंबर एक पहले लिखेंगे, कोई एलिमेंट स्टार्ट होने से पहले लिख रहे हैं, तो ये 2 क्या होगा? H से भी मल्टीप्लाई होगा, ये 2 O से भी मल्टीप्लाई होगा. ओके, अगर से आप H2O लिख रहे हैं, तो ये 2 H कितना है हमारे पास? 2 H है. आर यू गेटिंग चिल्ड्रन? हाउ मेनी वो वी हैव? ओनली वी हैव 1 O. अगर से मैं H2O3 लिख रहा हूँ, तो ये 2 H का है, ए ओ खाली 3 का है. अंडरस्टूड? ಯಾವಾಗ ನಾವು ಮುಂಚೆ ಬರಿತೀವಿ 2 ಅಂತ, ಅದು 2 ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಹೆಚ್ ಜೊತೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಓ ಜೊತೆ ಎರಡು ಜೊತೆನೂ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೈ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಈ 2 ಕೆಳಗಡೆ ಬರೆದ್ರೆ ಈ 2 ಬಂದು ಓನ್ಲಿ ಹೆಜ್ಗೆ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಇದೆ ಅಷ್ಟೇ. ಈ 2 ಬಂದು ಓನ್ಲಿ ಹೆಜ್ಗೆ ಇದೆ, ಈ 3 ಬಂದು ಓನ್ಲಿ ಓಗಿದೆ. ಅದೇ ನಾನು 2H2O3 ಅಂತ ಬರೆದ್ರೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, 2 2 4H ಆಯಿತು. ಎಷ್ಟಿದೆ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್? ನಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ 4 ಇದೆ. 2 3 6, ಅಂದರೆ ಓ ಎಷ್ಟಿದೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ? 6 ಇದೆ ಅಂತ. ಅರ್ಥವಾಯ್ತಾ? ದಿಸ್ 2 ಇಂಟು 2 4H, ದಿಸ್ 2 ಇಂಟು 3 6O. ಆರ್ ಯು ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್? ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್? ಎಸ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್. ಐ ಹೋಪ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್. ಓಕೆ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ಸ್, ಒನ್ ಯು ನೀಡ್ ಟು ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಸಮ್ ನೇಮ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಿಂಬಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ವಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಕಾಮನ್ಲಿ ಫಾರ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್. So which are those? Let's see. Yes, students, we can see here. So we have given some names and symbols of some common elements. You should know this. Okay. Observe your students. Some names. Element name aluminium we write as Al. Same way lead we write as Pb. Argon Ar. Magnesium Mg. Barium Ba. Manganese Mn. Boron B. Neon Ne. Bromine Br. Nitrogen N. Calcium Ca. Nickel Ni. Carbon C. Oxygen O. Chlorine Cl. Platinum Pt. Cobalt CO. Potassium K. Copper CO. Silicon Si. Fluorine F. Silver Ag. Gold Au. Sodium Na. Hydrogen H. Sulfur S. Helium He. Tin Sn. Iodine I. Uranium U. Iron Fe. Zinc Zn. Is this clear, children? So these are the actual symbols what we use. Okay. Now, after this, I just like to tell you one more important thing. Okay. What is that means? Sometimes, okay, you can see some have monoatomic ions. What is this? Monoatomic ions. Sir, what is the meaning of ions? Ions means positive and negative charge elements are known as ions. Okay. Anyways, how to dissociate into ions? Anything we are going to learn in the rest of the chapters, but you just need to know this. Mono means one. Means monoatomic ions. It is nothing but positively charged ions. They are positively charged ions. Mono means one. If we have seen monoatomic ions, if we have seen plus one charge, we will be having for some ions, like plus one charge will be there for some elements, and some elements have got plus two charge, some elements have got plus three charge on them, some elements have got plus four charge on them. Okay, dekho beta. एक एलिमेंट रहेगा, वो एलिमेंट के ऊपर कुछ चार्ज रहेगा, वो चार्ज आकर प्लस वन भी हो सकता है, प्लस टू, प्लस थ्री, प्लस फोर, ऐसा हर एलिमेंट का एक एक चार्ज होता है. जैसे कि एग्जाम्पल, फॉर एन एग्जाम्पल, हाइड्रोजन. हाइड्रोजन वी रेड एज एच प्लस, मीन्स इट हैज प्लस, मीन्स ओनली इट हैज प्लस वन चार्ज. उसके ऊपर कितना चार्ज है? बस एक ही चार्ज है. वन मोर एग्जाम्पल वी कैन टेक सोडियम. सो व्हाट इज द चार्ज ऑफ सोडियम? ओनली प्लस वन. ओनली वी राइट प्लस. वी राइट पोटेशियम K, we write only plus. Similarly, we write cuprous. Cuprous, that is Cu plus. Next, we write mercurous. What I am saying? Mercurous. Okay, that is Hg. That is Hg plus. And even we write silver. Ag plus. See, children, these all are monoatomic ions. Anyhow, they have only plus one charge. They have only plus one charge. Understood? So monoatomic ions, in monoatomic ions we have, okay, positively charged elements as well as negatively charged elements, both we have in monoatomic ions. Okay, next is plus two charge. We have cupric, which is having Cu two plus charge. Similarly, barium, Ba two plus charge ions. Next is calcium, Ca. Calcium has 2 plus charge ions. Next is mercuric Hg 2 plus. See, children, Hg only one charge is there, means mercurous. If it is having 2 charge, then we call it as mercuric. Similarly, cobalt has 2 plus charge. Similarly, nickel, we have 2 plus charge. Understood? Children, they won't ask you in exam, but you should know this. Okay. So in your further studies, definitely it will help you. You should not feel anything as I doesn't know. We write sometimes like this also, okay? Iron, can you see this? Like this type of symbols also we write. It means iron has 2 plus charge ions. If we say iron 2 means, it is indicated that iron which has 2 plus charge ions. Or it is also written as, ferrous, means Fe 2 plus ions. Okay, we write in this form also. Anyways, magnesium, Mg 2 plus charge ions. Manganese, it has Mn 2 plus charge ions. Zinc, it has 2 plus charge ions. Zinc. And similarly, we have this one. One more thing I just remember. That is lead. We write like this also. Lead instead of Pb, okay. We write like this also. Lead 2 means it has having 2 charge ions, 2 plus charge ions, or it is also written as plumbus. It is also called as plumbus, that is Pb 2 plus charge ions. Understood, children? So these are the elements which is having how much charge on them? 2, I mean plus 2 charge ions. Next is plus 3 charge. Who all have we have? Aluminium. Aluminium has 3 plus charge on them. Next we call like this iron. Like this means that is iron is having 3 plus charge ions. It is also called as ferric. It is also called as ferric. 3 plus. Okay. Next is chromium. It is having 3 plus charge ions on them. Next is bismuth. Bismuth. It is having 3 plus charge ions on them. Next is plus 4 charge. Who all we have? Lead. Lead have plus 4 charge ions. Or plumbic. Or plumbic. That is Pb. 4 plus charge ions. Next is platinum. Pt. Pt. It is having plus 4 charge ions. In case if you are taking in PU science, then definitely this charge, if you know, then your chemistry will become seriously very beautiful, and it is completely very interesting. It's completely very interesting. So you should know, in monatomic ions we have positively charged ions and negatively charged ions. Similarly, I can give you one more examples for monoatomic, means single. Mono means one, okay? Monoatomic ions which is having negatively charged ions. Negatively charged. So who all have negative charge? Who all have negative charge? Like example, we write minus 1 charge. Okay. Minus 2 charge. And minus 3 charge. Minus 3 charge. Okay. So which are those? Minus 1 charge. We have fluoride. We have fluoride, that is F minus. Next, chloride, Cl minus. Bromide, Br minus. Iodine, I minus. Hydride, H minus. Minus 2 charge. Sulfide, S2 minus. Oxide, O2 minus. Next is minus 3 charge. Phosphide, PHOS, PHID, phosphide. Okay, 3 minus ion. Nitride, N, 3 minus ions. Understood, children? So these are monoatomic positive and negative ions. If you write and keep, it will be helpful. Okay, anyways, next we have some common polyatomic ions. Poly means more than one. Poly means more than one. Polyatomic mass. Polyatomic mass means, example, we have plus 1 charge, we have minus 1 charge, we have minus 2 charge, we have minus 3 charge. So these elements are called as polyatomic elements. A polyatomic. Okay, plus 1, who have ammonia? See, poly means NH4. See, in mono means N is separate, H is separate. Poly means both combined together. We called as ammonium, that is having NH4 plus one charge. Next is hydroxide, OH, we write minus one charge. Bicarbonate, HCO3, bicarbonate. Nitrate, NO3, nitrate. Are you getting, children? This is important for you, children. In your, this is there for your exam, and we'll be using commonly this type of symbols. You should know this, okay? Next is acetate. Acetate, CH3COO, acetate. Next, minus two charge, who have we have? Carbonate, carbonate, CO3, it is having two minus charge on them. Sulfite, SO3, 2 minus. Sulfate, SO4, 2 minus. SO3 is sulfite. This is sulfate. Next is chromate. Chromate, CrO4, which is having 2 minus charge on them. Dichromate, Cr2O7, 2 minus charge on them. Next is phosphate, PO4, 3 minus charge on them. Phosphite, PHOS, PHITE, phosphite. Okay, that is PO3, 3 minus charge on them. Next is borate, BO3, 3 minus charge on them. Phosphide, P, 3 minus charge on them. Nitride, N, 3 minus charge on them. Are you getting, children? I hope you have understood what is the meaning of charges. Yes. So I hope you all have understood how to ensure the charges, monoatomic positive and negative charge and polyatomic charges. Still many things are there, children, to learn, but we no need to go so deep. Okay, in your syllabus it is not given. So we have I have given the extra information for you all. Okay, if you know that, it will be very much helpful. So anyways, children, in the next, I am going to stop this topic here itself for today's session, and in my next class I'll be going to discuss you how to balance the chemical equation. If it is unbalanced equation, how to convert them into balance. Seriously, I can teach you in very easiest way. Okay, so if you have if you have not studied a chemistry, okay, so I can teach you that chemistry like your life chemistry. Okay, so here you should learn these all things. You need to learn how to balance the equation and how to balance the ionic equations. Okay, anyhow, we are not only just dealing with your textbook, I am giving the extra information also which is beyond your textbook. So nowhere you need to find, no, my 8th standard has not gone well, my 9th standard has not gone well, sir, I didn't study last year. Okay, what I should know, how I should know. So these all things will be there. So this is actually the things which I have shown you, that is your 8th and 9th standard basics. But that basics is a very strong base to learn the rest of the contents of your next syllabus. Okay, you should not think this subject is difficult, that subject is difficult. Every subject is one and the same. Okay, so I'll be teaching you not only with respect to your textbook, even the contents which is given in the textbook, even beyond contents also, somewhere which is related to this, I'll be teaching you. I'm not teaching you everything, don't worry. I'm going to teach you which is related to our subject and which is related to the chapter. Okay, so these all basics anyhow we are going to cover here. But only thing is, your dedication should be here. Your dedication, your efforts, your interest plays a very major role. Okay, so these all things which I have shown you in the above things, like atomic masses, all those things. Okay, these all things you should know. Without knowing these things, you cannot learn chemistry, seriously. You have to and you must need to learn these things. And even you should know how to pronounce, how to write the symbols. Okay, So these all symbols, okay, elements, names, symbols, these all are very, very, very important if you want to learn science. Okay. Anyways, wish you all the best of luck. Do well. Is this clear? So if you have liked this video, please do not forget to comment below how was today's session, how was this session especially. Okay. Every class, if you are going to comment me, even I will also let I myself know what I am doing, so what I can do the best for you for the next period. I will get to know. If you are not commenting below, then how can I ensure what I have done, how you have understood? Okay, how was your class? Definitely you need to comment, because you have spent more than an hour. Okay, your dedication, seriously, it's I can thanks for you people for cooperating with me, and you're watching an hour video continuously and making the notes, practicing. Seriously, children, it's wonderful. So this dedication, this effort should be there till the last moment, not only like a boiling bubbles. When it is boiling water, the bubbles formation we can see. After that, what happens? It collapse. We cannot see at all those bubbles, right? It should not happen. These bubbles should be there till the last day of our exam. Always you should be in that condition, like a hot bubbles, right? Fine. So anyhow, you can subscribe to our channel to get the latest updates and videos. Like this video and comment below how was the session. So I'll be coming with you all in the next period, still more very interesting facts and figures. Thank you. Wish you all the best of luck. Do well.